Hi guys, my name is Janmin Lisandra, and today I will be demonstrating on how I painted this painting. So first of all guys, you need to subscribe to my YouTube channel in order to see all my coming videos and tutorials.
Okay guys, so before I'm going to start the painting tutorial, I'm going to introduce to you first my materials. I have here my paint palette. I have the titanium white, the tallow blue, the medium, no, the brilliant red, the medium yellow, the lamp black. So you always observe guys that I am always using limited colors in my palette because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. Okay, and these are my brushes. I have 2 inches flat brush. You can also 1 inch flat brush, guys. I have number 11 flat brush long handle. The size of the bristle is almost like 1 inch. It's as big as 1 inch. And I have here the 12 inches. No, sorry guys. It's number 12 flat brush short handled. And I have here also the number 9 flat brush short handled, and I have the number 11 round brush short handled, and I have also here number, I guess it's number 1 or number 2 of a round brush or liner brush for the details. Okay, and water guys to thin the paint. And this is my canvas guys. It's 10 by 12 inches. It has 3 coats of prime gesso. I made this myself. Okay, so I'm going to start now with the background colors first. So since I'm going to paint water lilies guys, I'm going to add the background color first, the color of the water, then I'm going to start the water lilies, then the flowers. Okay, so that will be my plan guys. And first I'm going to use the flat brush 2 inches. I don't know guys if it is 2 inches, it's just like more than 1 inch, or I don't know, but you can also use 2 inches guys of one inches. Okay, so I think I'm gonna use I'm thinking of making it green, color green. So I'm gonna use dark green or bluish green. So I'm gonna use first the blue to make some green color, and of course the yellow, and also red guys. I'm going to add more blue color, so just mix some vertical strokes like this. So I'm adding yellow, green, and also red guys. This will be the reflection of the water guys. So I'm gonna do first the water before I'm gonna paint the water lilies. So I'm gonna use this white guys to make the lighter color, then just spray the colors here, the lighter color, something like bluish, or I think it looks like blue green guys. Yeah, and I'm going to add some blue color also, some red. So you just have to play the colors guys, and don't be afraid to apply it on your canvas. I'm gonna add the white here to make some light color. My advice guys, just don't afraid to use the colors or to apply it to the canvas. I'm gonna use the yellow and with a little amount of red to mix some orange color. I'm going to apply it here directly. I'm gonna add the yellow. And some more blue guys. And of course the red and yellow. And I think I'm going to apply a little black. And red and blue. So make it the stroke should be vertical from top to bottom or vice versa. More blue guys with yellow to make some greens. So just follow what I'm doing, guys. Some more yellows and orange. And I think I'm going to add some blue, guys. Some darker blue here in the corner with black to make it darker with a little amount of red. Yeah, again, all yellow. More yellow and white. This will be some reflection from the... I think I'm going to assume that there will be a forest on the back or on top of this pond, guys, or river or a lake. Okay, we have now these horizontal backgrounds. Okay, and we're going to use the white with a little amount of blue, guys, here. And I use it here on the bottom. Then we're gonna add a little amount of black to make it darker or grayish. So let's add it here. We're gonna make them some vertical strokes from top to bottom. Just like what I'm doing, guys. I'm just stopping or punching. I use the candice blue, guys, here with a little bit of yellow. I think this will just be an easy tutorial, guys. Okay, so if it feels hard, guys, just dip the tip of your brush into the water to make it a little wet. And so it won't be hard to apply it on canvas. That's one technique, guys. I'm using acrylic. You should use the water. Okay, so I'm gonna use the yellow again with some red. And I'm going to apply it here more. I'll just glazing, guys, or adding more coats, thin coats on the on top of every coat, guys, or every layers. It's actually, guys, another way of blending the colors. So I just keep on adding more coats, and I think I'm gonna use the black, guys. I like darker what I call this, darker reflection of the water. So I'm gonna use the black and blue, guys, here. Anyway, guys, we just have to cover this part with lots of water lilies. Yeah, we're gonna do it later. And we're gonna let it dry first before we're gonna do it, so that it won't be hard to add the layers. Over here. So if you're using Liquitex Basics, guys, or the student grade acrylics, so the problem is that you need to add more coats before gonna reach the solidity of the colors or the perfect solid colors. So if you want to avoid that, you need to use an expensive acrylics or the artist quality, which has more pigments than then basic or the student quality. So what else I'm gonna put? So I think I'm going to add more codes here. There's horizontal stroke, guys. You can use any colors that come to your mind. I'm just have to keep on adding more codes. That's the technique, guys. Okay, I think I am okay with this, so I think I'm gonna let it dry first for at least 5 minutes. Then I'm gonna go back adding the details, guys, like the what they call this, the plants and the the water lilies and the flowers. Okay, guys, so let it dry first and just go back later. Okay, guys, so I think the paint is already dry now and I'm going to start adding the details. So I think I'm going to start adding the, or I'm going to add first the leaves of the water lilies. Okay, and I'm going to start by mixing first the green color. So I'm gonna use the blue, the yellow, of course, and white, and some more blue, more yellow. I think I'm gonna add more yellow, guys, with a little amount of red to make it a little matured. Yeah, so here I'm gonna add a little white, make it a little lighter. So you just have to add the paints, guys, little by little. So I'm using the number 11 flat brush, guys, long handled. Okay, so I'm gonna do this by painting the water lilies. Can I do first the circles? It should be large or big lips, guys, and it should be take all this round, but make it oblong, guys, in shape, so that it will have some perspective. And we're gonna add a little curve, guys, like this. It's what the water lily looks like, guys, the leaves of the water lily. Okay, and also here. First, guys, we just have to fill the colors with this with the green color. Just have to fill it with the green color. Then later we're gonna add the painting size or the shadings or the details. And here also. Okay. So I'm gonna add more yellow, guys, in red. And to use some more yellows and more blue to make some more greens and red. More yellows with a little amount of white. Okay, so what's next? So I'm gonna put more here. So let's add some more yellow color on this lily, guys, on these leaves. Okay, and here also. Let's add more perspective. Yeah, I think here also, guys. Also. Okay. I'm going to add more blue, guys, to make it more bluish. Mm. And more white. Okay. Make it lighter. Okay. Mm, here also. So we don't have to. We do not have to make it perfect crop, guys. Make it darker. Yeah. And here also. Okay, so we have now a perspective, guys. So this part, guys, should be bigger than the farther or the nearer should be bigger. Okay, of course. Here also. Okay. So there have been lots of water leaks in this. On this pan, guys. Okay, so you do not have to make it do it perfectly, guys. Okay, here also. Okay, now here. So this part, guys, we can add some built-in lines. So just glazing, guys. Do not wet your brush. Okay. Yeah, I think that's okay. Yeah, perfect. And now we can add some shading, guys. Some shadings on our water lily. So again, I use this number 12 flat brush, short handled. So you see, guys, that it's way smaller than the other one we used before, or a while ago. And I'm gonna use this black, guys, dark color. So gonna put shadings on the shadow part. Yeah. And we're gonna use the black and blue and yellow. More blue and red. So we have now the dark color, guys. We're gonna add more black. So we have now darker colors, guys. So here we can add more shading. So do not make it straight, guys. Make some irregular. Make it irregular like this. Okay, so here also this will create more depths or also perspective, guys. I'm gonna make it lighter and make it plain a little here. Just blend it a little here. Okay. Yeah, that's it. So, and here also, guys, we're gonna make it. We're gonna add some. Don't know what to call this, guys, but it's how the water is look. Okay. And anything here also, and here. And I'm gonna add more dark color. I think I'm gonna do more here. Okay, so there's no special technique guys in adding this dark tones or shadings or shadows or whatever you call it. You just have to fill this part with dark colors. Hey, I think I need to add more groups here. Hey. In here also. You don't have to do it perfectly guys. Okay, what about that? In here also guys. Continue doing it guys until the last part. Hopefully you don't have to do it all of it in the in the further part, so you just have to add some lines, some dark lines to create an impression. Yeah, that's how I did it. Yeah, and here also. Yeah, about that. And we're gonna add more, I think I'm going to add more details on the water lilies guys. I'm going to add more shadings or lights or more details. Yeah, so I'm going to use again the bigger brush, the number 11 flat brush, long handled. This will make the work faster guys. And I'm going to use this white here. I'm going to mix for yellow and blue to make lighter green. White, more white. Yeah. Okay. So let's do it this way. Actually, guys, you can use a smaller brush if you are having a difficulty using this brush. So let's just do it this way. Okay. So just do it here, but don't overdo it guys. Remember not to overdo it, as I was telling you that overdoing is not really good. It's like eating too much guys, it's not really good. So again, add a little brownish in color here to add more brown color in our quaternary leaves. This will add more to the realistic effect. Okay. And here also. Yeah. And here. You do not need to make it perfect, guys. Like this one, a picture. Just make it looks like real. Yeah. Yeah. I think that's it. Also, I think I'm gonna use a smaller brush, guys. I think this brush number 9, but brush, it's way smaller. And I'm gonna mix for another lighter green color. So I'm gonna use the white, blue, and blue. So more white. Okay, here we can add more light highlights. So we don't overdo it, guys. Yeah, that's it. And I think also here. And use your fingers. And I think here, guys. How about that? And here also. So make some curves, guys. These. Yeah. And also here. Let's create more art. Okay. Here also. And I think here. The painting is a little impressionistic. Okay. Yeah, I think it looks real in the video, guys. Yeah, I like that. I like it. So now I'm going to start adding the flowers, guys. I think the flowers will be much more easier. Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to use. I'm going to use this on number 11 round brush, guys. It's a little pointed. Okay, so this is how you're gonna make the flowers, guys. Gonna use the pure white. No, I'm going to paint the white flowers at the color is the water lilies. So I'm gonna use this white, guys, but I'm gonna add more a little black with some little blue, or it should be a little gray, yes, guys, first. So this will be shadings. So this will serve as shadings, guys, and you can add highlights later, which is the white, the pure white. Okay, so we're gonna use this white. Okay. I'm gonna put some here. So just one sock. So I think that's pretty easy. One sock. One socks. Okay. So just one sock, guys. Okay. So if it feels hard, guys, just dip the tip of your tip of your brush into the water like this. So just small amount, guys, in the water. And to make it a little wet, and it will flow freely in the canvas. Especially, I guess, if your canvas has no crown, so that will be a little hard to execute. And then add more. Okay. Okay, this one, so guys, don't be afraid to. To execute. Okay, I'm gonna add a little amount of black to make it a darker. Okay. Also, I think I'm going to add more here, on here. Okay. I think that's very easy, guys. Okay, that's it. So you just have to follow what I'm doing here, guys. If you want to paint with me. Okay, that's it. So, we can add more here. So you should always remember, guys, that the farther an object, it will become smaller. Like what I'm doing. Okay, so it's smaller than this, than this. So I'm gonna add more white and the blue. With a little bit of blue to make it darker. Or bluish or bluish gray. Okay, so what else? So, now, add one here. Okay. Now, it's really easy. Okay, one more here. And here. And here. Okay, so the farther it is, guys, the smaller it is. Can I fill it with water lilies? Can I make this sword beautiful by painting more water lilies? Okay, and here. And there. So use the tip of your round brush, guys, to make more small water lilies. Like that. Okay, let's continue, guys. I can add one here. So the same technique, guys. And here. And there. There. Getting really lots of weather, ladies. So what else we gonna do with this? Okay, so what else? So I think we're gonna add more. Yeah. And I think we're gonna add more, okay? Okay, we need to mix more gray, guys. So I'm gonna use this gray and white in with a little amount of people. I'm going to apply it here. Oh, I'm going to add a bigger one here. And now, guys, we're gonna add the highlights, guys, with this the pure white. So we just have to use this pure white here, and we're gonna apply it on top of every color. I don't know if it's not so visible, so I think I'm going to adjust the exposure. Yeah, I'm going to adjust the exposure, guys. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, I think that will be a little visible, guys. So I just adjust the exposure of the camera. So here, just a little more white here. To create something like the highlights, guys. Okay. That's it. And here. Don't overdo it, guys. Just make it just don't overdo it. I mean, guys, what we're doing is adding more whites. So you should control your feelings, guys, when adding the highlights. Don't put everything in it. But that's what I mean with everything, guys. So here, so add it on top of the color, guys, the one you first added. Hey, So I'll be stopping there, adding the highlights on the further part to this. Okay. So here also. Yeah, that's it. Just a little bit of it. Okay, got that. Okay, then I'm going to add something like shading, guys. So it is also shading, guys. And it will be a little dark green, yeah. So I'm gonna add first the lighter green, guys. So I'm gonna use this yellow and blue and white to make it lighter green here. And I'm gonna add some shadings here to be darker. So I'm gonna use the blue. So just one stroke, guys, top to bottom. Okay, and here a little, and here, here. Okay, that's enough. So let's add darker green color. So I'm gonna use this blue, guys, with red, with yellow and red to make some darker green color. Okay. So can you? I think I'm gonna add one here. Okay. And here. Yeah. Okay. Just one side, don't overdo it, guys. As I told you, don't overdo it. And here also, guys. This one's so here. Okay, I'm gonna add some dark shadings, guys. Dark shadings on the bottom of the flower. So I'm gonna use the black. And I'm gonna add the black here. And the blue. So I'm gonna put it here. And also the reflection, guys. Yeah. About that. Well, I think I'm almost done, guys. Yeah. Okay, so I think I'm going to add some details, guys. So I think I'm going to clarify this one. So I'm going to add some details. Yeah, like this. To make this dark. Okay. This one, guys. To the center. And we can add some colors here. And shades or details on the leaves. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, I like it. I do not know yet, but I think I am already contented with this, with the result. I'm thinking that's what else I'm gonna add on this painting to make it more real. I think, guys, I am done with my simple painting tutorial, guys. I think it's just about 45 minutes the whole tutorial, so that's pretty fast. So I think I am done, guys. So hopefully, guys, you get something out of this painting or simple painting tutorial tonight or today. So hopefully, guys, you learn from my method or the way I teach. Okay. So my advice, guys, to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you know how to mix the colors. Because that's why I'm using the limited colors in the palette, guys. And if you're not painting, just follow everything I did in this video. And guys, please subscribe or please hit like, add some comments, and subscribe for more videos in the future. And good luck guys if you are painting now. And I want to say thank you so much and have a nice day.